Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. Now, last time we focused on the Queen, and we were particularly exposing the Queen of Bermuda Triangle, where the throne of Lucifer is located, and we explained the roles of the Queen, who controls all the four corners of the earth. And today we want to enter into yet another controversial presentation inside the Word of God. Yet this will be a presentation that is meant to give awareness unto the seven churches of Jesus Christ. So for us to understand more on this presentation, let's get inside the Word of God. In the book of Revelations, chapter 2, verse 18. And the passage that I'm going to be reading here is a presentation in which John the Revelator was writing letters unto the seven churches of Jesus Christ. And it so happens that among these seven churches that he was writing letters unto, there was a church among the seven churches that he writes a specific letter addressing this matter. And it reads, "And unto the angel of the church in Thyatira, I write, these things saith the Son of God, who has his eyes like unto flames of fire, and his feet are like fine brass. I know thy works, and charity, and service, and faith, and thy patience, and thy works, and the last to be more than the first." Meaning that in all the letters that John the Revelator wrote, he writes letters unto the seven churches of Jesus Christ, giving good credit of the works, the service, the faith, the love of that church. And notwithstanding, there are things that he then writes unto the same church, criticizing certain activities that are not inspired by the Son of God. "Notwithstanding, I have a few things against you, because you have suffered that woman called Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols." The servants that are being referred there, which are being seduced by Jezebel, are the prophets. The prophets represent the eye of the church. And John the Revelator, like I explained in the presentation called John the Revelator, John the Revelator is above prophets. This is why he writes letters unto the seven churches. And remember, like I said, the spirit that was now upon John the Revelator is the same spirit of Elijah that once reigned upon John the Baptist. And the same John the Baptist is the one that Jesus earlier referred that of all the prophets, there is none like John. And he further describes John as more than a prophet, meaning that the spirit that was now upon John the Revelator was the spirit that was more than prophets, which gave him capacity to address seven churches with letters that were referred unto the prophets of those churches. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying. But the letter that is being written unto the church in Thyatira is a mystery letter, which resembles certain points, certain issues that need to be fixed by that church. Their service, their faith, their love, their works have been endorsed. But there is something that has been criticized in written inside the letters written by John. The works of the spirit of Jezebel inside that church. Meaning that the church in Thyatira was hijacked by the spirit of fornication. And the spirit of fornication that was hijacking this church, which is among the seven churches that were being addressed by several letters, is that Jezebel was controlling even the operations of the elders and the leaders of the church. Meaning that the spirit of Jezebel was controlling even the prophets, which I am describing as the sex prophets. Why? Because when a church is operating under the spirit of Jezebel, and the prophet of that church is also a victim of the same spirit, he becomes a sex prophet by virtue of not being led by the Holy Spirit, but being led by another spirit, which is not holy, but horny. There is a horny spirit. I remember addressing this spirit in some of my presentations, so that you understand that Lucifer the devil has entered churches in a different format, in a different dimension of evil, to inflict churches by lust and to divert the works of the Holy Spirit unto the works of men, which become the works of the flesh. And instead of the prophets of the church ministering deliverance unto those that are afflicted by the spirit of lust, they end up being the ones that fulfill the lust. And a church then becomes a church of sex prophets who are inspired by many lusts of sex. There are those that they call one-on-one, in which a prophet is either counseling to a female one-on-one in his office, in his so-called prophetic office, or a prophet is counseling a couple. All those, they've given birth to many scandals of prophets that end up having sex with the congregation members. I need you to understand that I'm presenting the sex prophets, and the sex prophets, they've been inspired by the spirit of Jezebel, and they are actually churches that have been constructed by sex. And they are actually churches that have been built by an occult of sex, whereby the more a prophet is having sex with his own members, that church also grows. It does not grow under the inspiration or the influence of the Holy Spirit, but that church grows under the defiled influence of sex, where fornication is committed inside that church, where fornication is never exposed in that church. And John is writing to the church in Thyatira, saying, notwithstanding, I have a few things against you. Why? Because you have suffered that woman that is called Jezebel, which calls herself a prophetess. Even Jezebel called herself a prophetess. Meaning that if one becomes a sex prophet, what is then referred unto that prophet who is later converted into a sex prophet is a prophetess who has got a spirit of Jezebel. Meaning that there's a level of a prophetess according to sex, not according to the anointing of the Holy Spirit, but according to the empowerment of evils, of Jezebels. And she operates in that church to inspire sexual activities. And the church that John has written a letter unto is a church that now has a record of many sexual activities. And though this church has been endorsed in other areas, it has failed in that specific area of seduction, being seduced into sexual activities. And because you have suffered that woman called Jezebel, which calls herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. And I gave a space to repent of her fornication, and she repented not. What the Lord is referring to here is the Old Testament dimension, in which the significance of Jezebel began. For there was a woman that reigned under the kingdom of King Ahab, and she was in charge and did evil in the sight of the Lord. And her name was Jezebel. And Jezebel fed almost 300 to 400 prophets. And only Elijah was the prophet that escaped the wrath of the lust of Jezebel. And those prophets, they operated under the lust of Jezebel. Meaning that we have a majority of prophets that are operating under this spirit. It's not only the spirit of Jezebel, but the spirit of fornication. And by virtue of that spirit of fornication, they become the spirits that are enticed. And they get enticed to become sex prophets. Now, I need you to understand that God is inspiring John the Revelator to write letters unto the churches. And unto the letter that is written unto this church, he says, behold, I will cast her into bed. And he is referring unto Jezebel that is operating inside that church. But he's not referring unto Jezebel. He's referring unto the spirit that is operating inside the prophets, inside the elders, inside the congregation, and them that commit adultery. Why? What manner of adultery is God talking about here? I need you to understand that way before even the New Testament, God has described his tabernacle, his temple, his church as the nation of Israel. And the children of Israel, they were given a mandate to submit to their Lord God as their husband. And that tradition continued unto the New Testament, in which God resembles the church as his wife, which is now the church of Jesus Christ. And Jesus is the one that has signified the church as his wife. And the adultery that is being referred here is not just adultery in terms of fornication and adultery in the physical, in the lustful commitment, in the practicality of the commitment of that sin, but the adultery of defiling those that have fled away from the presence of God. The moment one has fled away from the presence of God, the moment a congregation has fled away from the presence of God, it is regarded as a congregation that is committing adultery. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying. And the Lord God says, I will kill your children with death, and all the churches shall know. Which other churches? The other six churches. Meaning that the church that is being addressed of fornication, which is the church in Thyatira, which is the church which John the Revelator writes the letters unto, is the church which God wants to use as an example unto other churches. Why? Because this is the church of sex prophets. The church that is not delivered from sexual activities. The church that has suffered Jezebel to continue operating, though there are other divine activities that are being done, there will still be other activities of sex being committed. And the mark of adultery is the mark that is produced when a congregation is now stuck into the sin of fornication and committing adultery instead of serving its husband, who is Jesus Christ, who is the owner of the wife, who is the owner of the church. There's a scripture that is inspired by Apostle Paul, where he says, if one has joined his body with that of a harlot, and is referring to that body being the temple of God, which would have joined itself with the body of a harlot, that body becomes defiled. And this is adultery that would have committed. Why? Because your body is the temple of Jesus Christ. Why? Because your body is resembled as the wife of Jesus Christ. Why? Because your body is meant to be preserved. Why? Because it is married. It is resembled as a church. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying. The mark of adultery inside the church of sex prophets is signified in the process when the church has fled away from the presence of God. I hope someone is understanding what I'm saying. And God says, I'll cast her into the deathbed, referring to the church. Now, God, let's go to the book of Hosea, Prophet Hosea, chapter 1, verse 1. And it reads, now the word of the Lord came unto Hosea, the son of Beeri. And the word of the Lord, in the beginning of the word of the Lord by Hosea, and the Lord says unto Hosea, go take unto thyself a wife of whoredoms and the children of whoredoms, for the land has committed great whoredom, departing from the Lord. Why is the Lord commanding prophet Hosea to go and take unto himself the wife of whoredoms? Why? Because the land of Israel, the child of Israel, has fled away from the presence of God. And remember, God is resembled as the husband. And now Israel has got a mark of adultery, and he has fled away from the presence of God. And upon fleeing away from the presence of God, he has produced a mark, a sign of adultery on his forehead. Just like the church in Thyatira that has fled away from the presence of God. And God wants to demonstrate through prophet Hosea what he feels like. So he tells prophet Hosea, marry unto yourself a wife of whoredoms, so that you can understand my position. This is not the first time that the Lord God has done this. He has demonstrated a punishment unto King David. And he sends prophet Nathan after David has slept with Uriah's wife. And he tells David in parables that your wives shall be laid with in the sight of all Israel. And the son of David, who was Absalom, is the one that laid with his father's concubines in the sight of all Israel. We have seen it when Samson is given the mandate to deliver Israel, but he chooses to take unto himself a wife of the Philistine, and further chooses again to join himself with Delilah, who represents the wife of Otom. And Samson is able to deliver Israel without his two eyes, the same eyes that lasted. Why? Because God wanted to demonstrate himself. We have seen it when Phineas and Hophni, the two sons of Eli, were busy sleeping with the temple women, and the Lord God came and slew them. Child of God, I want you to understand that the Lord God has demonstrated a punishment, a severe punishment, unto all the sex prophets. When I'm talking about the sex prophets, I'm talking about those that have been given the mandate to preach the word, but they have been diverted from the word, and they ended up fulfilling the lust of the flesh. When I'm talking about the sex prophets, I'm talking about those that are supposed to be canceling marriages, but instead of canceling marriages, they end up fulfilling lust unto the married couples. They end up sleeping with the married women. When I'm talking about the sex prophets, I'm talking about the prophets that are bedding girls. When I'm talking about the sex prophets, I'm talking about the prophets that do not have the Holy Spirit, but they have been possessed by a Holy Spirit. When I'm talking about the sex prophets, I'm talking about a generation of prophets that eat and dine on the table of Jezebel, who dined with the 400 prophets of Baal. Child of God, You are being given a chance by the Holy Spirit, so that the anointing that is in you to save God does not end up saving the devils of Jezebel. Child of God, you are being given the anointing that defeats the sex prophets. Child of God, you are being given the empowerment to defeat the mark of adultery, so that you and those that you lead, you are not going to flee away from the presence of God. In the name of Jesus.
Cover us, Jesus. The blood.